Corpse Middleweight Madness, Saturday, March 18th.
James, held at IFL TV in association with MTK Global. We're in New York City, big fight week. Quite fortunate enough to be joined by the head of Scotland, the Prime Minister of Scotland, and the main man for independence, none other than Sam Kinnock. What's happening, Sam?
I'm very well, thank you, James. How are you?
I'm very well. Just before we go into boxing, are you for Scotland leaving or staying?
Staying, actually. Part of the Remain, don't think it's a good idea. So I shan't go into it too much, but don't think it's a good idea. Don't think it's a good idea.
Let's talk a little bit about the reasons that we're here. You've got a fighter on the Golovkin Danny Jacobs undercard, which is quite interesting in itself.
Yep.
Jay McFarlane, a bit of a character to say the least. Talk to me a little bit first about him.
So Jay, young heavyweight, he's just turned 19 last week. He's 2-0, two knockouts thus far. His first two fights have been in Glasgow, and then third fight we found ourselves here at Madison Square Garden. So, as you say, he's quite a character. He's had the kilt on this week, some face paint, and he's going down a storm over here. Now it's just down to doing business tomorrow. So, as well as managing Jay, I'm doing his corner tomorrow night. So just looking after him. I've been doing some gym sessions, staying on top of things. So he's looking good.
He looks like a really good prospect, as you mentioned. He's very powerful. He looks a bit raw at times, but very, very, very powerful.
Yeah, he is, and that's exactly what I would say. Raw, he's a work in progress, but at just turned 19, he could indeed spend the next 5 years building up, progressing, developing, because he's not a massively tall heavyweight. He's 6'3", so he needs to grow into the division. He has a very, very small heavyweight, so we need to grow him into the division. He'll learn, but as you say, he's got that explosive power, so he's going to be exciting on the way. So
it's good to see young fighters getting opportunities on such a big undercard, because when it comes to the future and travelling to go and fight, he's already got that experience under his belt, which could prove invaluable.
Yeah, exactly. We've been here for the full fight week, so he's had press conference, weigh-in, been around it all, so it's good. He's just taking everything in. It'll only really be probably looking back that he'll realise how much he's learned from this trip, so it's invaluable experience, both for him and I. Mean, a big show over here in the States, there's certain elements of it which are different, so it's really good to take in, but I can see he's absorbing it all, and it'll stand him in good stead.
I just see via social media that David Brophy's won the Commonwealth title. I haven't had a chance to watch the fight yet because I've been out here and the time difference and stuff, but that's massive, massive news for Brophy, isn't it? To go away.
Phenomenal. Yeah, it's great. When the fight was first tabled, David jumped at it, and from our team at MTK, we all looked at it. We all liked the look of the fight as well. Zach Dunn was undefeated Commonwealth champion. Brophy's record only blemished by the loss to Groves, so he was so keen to kind of right that wrong. Just everything felt right about it, and he's went over there and he's done a job. And full credit to David and Billy Nelson, his trainer, as well. It's been a long journey for both of them together as a team, so it's really good to see their hard work come to fruition, and obviously holding that Commonwealth title, which for MTK as a team is great. And for David himself, I know he's over the moon. So I was trying to watch the stream, but we've been over here in the States, it kept stopping, so I was having to look at
so frustrating.
People's comments were kind of informing me as to how it was going, but I know he hurt him in the third and he stopped him in the seventh with body shots.
How proud are you, Brophy, the fact that he did take such a beating against George Groves in that fight? He was disappointed in his own performance, publicly said that.
Yeah, absolutely.
He didn't feel he performed to his best, so How sort of pleased are you for him, the fact that he's gone out there and redeemed himself in such fashion?
He didn't do himself any justice in that fight, and it's redemption for David, and I just know he's going to be so happy. But as a man, he's such a proud fighting man, it's great for him, and I think it's onwards and upwards from here. And in terms of the story of MTK, David was one of the first Scottish boxers to join up with us. He headlined that first show up in Glasgow, where I were lucky enough to have IFL there. So you know, it's a good little story. He's went from a good eight rounder there, built up, had the shot against Groves, we've got him straight back, rebuilt him, and now he's a Commonwealth champion. So onwards and upwards from there. The super middleweight division's filled with talent, so exciting fights down the line for David.
Do you expect to see Brophy defending that Commonwealth title in Glasgow, or is it a case of looking for bigger pastures for Brophy?
Well, we make decisions as a team, so we'll just have to see, but I think the natural would be David's a big draw in Scotland. We'd like to see him defending that title in Scotland, because we've had two Box Nation dates in Scotland, but we haven't had a Scottish champion within the team, and now we've got that. It's a natural headliner, be it for a televised show or a non-televised show. David's a big draw in his own right, but now that he's Commonwealth champion, I think it just takes him to a new level in terms of popularity, appeal, and the fights that can be made for him.
Fair play, bro. One fight interests me coming up in Scotland is Charlie Edwards taking on Ian Butcher,
yeah,
which I think is a tremendous scrap.
I love that fight, and I know both the boxers, and obviously they're both MTK, and it's one of the few fights that's a genuine 50-50. Both great guys, and that's going to be really good. I think that I personally think that's going to steal the show on April 15th in Glasgow. They've both really got a point to prove. It's a pivotal stage in both boxers' careers, and yeah, it's going to be an absolute cracker.
Like you mentioned, it's fantastic to see MTK matching some of their fighters against each other, which they're both very talented fighters. Is that right? They are both
absolutely
strong fighters in that division.
Yep, for both of them. It's a real pivotal fight, and it made sense. You know, it's a British title. It makes sense for both boxers, and as a management team, we have to do what's right for the boxers. And in this instance, for those two to meet on that bill made sense. And we've made some other matches, kind of all MTK recently, and that's what we're looking to do. Ultimately, boxers have to meet one another in order to succeed, and we've got such a big stable now that there's a lot of natural matches there. We had a good one recently with Ryan Moorhead against Jordan McCory up in Scotland, and we've got some other MTK matches kind of in the works. So
Tyrone McKenna, Sean Green was a good fight as well in Ireland. Them guys matched them up quite well, I think.
Yeah, exactly. And Tyrone's one of the boxers in the camp that's doing well, and there's other light welters there that look like there'll be matches for him down the line, and there's a lot of talk on social media about him against Phil Sutcliffe. It's all about the timing being right, but that's just from a step back from a fan's perspective, that's a really exciting fight. So yeah, Butcher, Edwards, I'm genuinely excited about. And two nice guys, two great pros, so may the best man win.
What's happening with Gary Cornish at the moment? Is there anything you can sort of tell us regarding him?
So Gary's in line to box for the British title. We're just awaiting a date for that now, and it'll be Gary Cornish against Sam Sexton. So we're really confident of Gary coming out the victor there, and then hopefully onwards and upwards for Gary. We had a plan in place for Gary whereby he was rebuilding, because we felt that the Joshua fight, when it had been made, was too soon for him. He didn't have the right build up, so we're just looking to get him busy and incrementally build up level of opposition. But being made mandatory for the British title doesn't come round too often, so we've jumped at this opportunity. Gary was actually scheduled to box Sam Sexton before, and Sexton withdrew, so it's not as if he's taking a big jump up. No disrespect to Sam Sexton, but it was a fight that was due to happen before. I think it's a genuine 50-50, and it's a great opportunity for Gary.
Tonight, sort of the jewel in the crown of the MTK, like Michael Conlon in action, his debut, top rank endorsed, massive platform, massive show. What can we expect from him?
I just think he's going to steal the show. I mean, he's just he's a supreme athlete. The level at which he's been competing with him, being WSB and obviously in the Olympic sort of setup for several years, I think he's going to hit the ground running. I think tonight will be massive. Just being here in New York, I've been saying to Jay as we've been going around this fight week, it doesn't feel like we're in New York. All the people we know from Belfast are here, and all the rest of the guys, so it's a really great atmosphere, and I think Michael's going to steal the show. And obviously the top rank setup, they've got him streamlined, his route to the top will be a smooth and fast one, so just can't wait to see the start of his journey tonight.
Do you think there'll be future link-ups with other MTK fighters potentially fighting on the undercard and so forth?
I think it would be great, and it would be a natural if it could happen, because obviously Michael is such a big part of the sort of setup they've got at top rank, and it would definitely make sense. So it's good, and it's nice that it's tying in that obviously I'm involved with the J&J's on the next night, so it's good. It's one of the biggest weekends in boxing. To be part of it is a treat, both obviously here supporting Michael as an MTK boxer, and then Jay on the next night is just brilliant.
Top of the bill, Glenn Lofton, Danny Jacobs, everyone's excited about the fight, everyone's got an opinion. You can't help but like Danny Jacobs. He's just such a great guy. Lofton, the same way. The way he conducts himself out of the ring is impeccable. His performance in the ring set the speech for itself. So what sort of fight are we expecting from this?
From my perspective, I think Jacobs' approach would be to go for him. He's such a massive puncher, such a quick starter, that I think Golovkin likes to work his way into a fight and suss his opponent out sometimes. So I expect to see Jacobs go for him early, and I think it could be quite a short, explosive fight, but I just can't see beyond a Golovkin win. Really like Jacobs, but I just cannot see beyond a Golovkin win. I think there could be some hairy moments early on, but I see Golovkin coming out on top, and I think people are reading too much into the Brook performance. I think Golovkin knew he had his measure and had a relatively cavalier approach, whereas here I think he's going to be fully switched on, and he's aware of the power that Jacobs carries.
Great fight, Irish Andy Lee coming back into the fight. What seems an eternity since we last seen him in the ring, that's Billy Joe Saunders. I mean, that must have been a frustrating move for himself.
Yeah, Andy Lee's a great boxer. I admired him from afar for many years, so it'd be great to see him live in action tomorrow night. Devastating right hook. A really, really genuinely nice guy. He's been around all fight week and been really nice, and been really nice to Jay, and spent a bit of time with him. So looking forward to seeing him back in action. I think he'll be a force in the middleweight division. I mean, it's not beyond the possibility that by the end of the year we could be seeing Andy against the winner of Golovkin Jacobs. And obviously with him being on the belt, we'd suggest that that can happen. So yeah,
he's got a real shot window, hasn't he, to showcase himself and push himself forward.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's a great opportunity for him with it happening on St. Paddy's weekend as well. Obviously at the weigh-in today, you can see a lot of people there conscious of the fact that Andy was weighing in and there to support him. So it's good. It's a great platform for him, as you say, to have been out for so long. At least he's coming back in a really great fashion.
Big weekend of boxing. Thank you very much, Sam. I appreciate your time, mate.
Thank you, James. Cheers.